Hello everyone, my name is Professor Polish, and in this section I'll be talking to you about the challenges of CMP. CMP is a very complicated step in the manufacturing of semiconductors. Consequently, there are many challenges, such as defectivity, non-uniformity, dishing, and erosion, just to name a few. However, with the right tools, testing, and knowledge, these challenges can be overcome. Before we discuss all the things that can go wrong with CMP, it is important to touch on some very sophisticated and expensive metrology equipment and our dedicated and trained experts that use them. What we are often looking for are scratches, pits, debris, sometimes only a few tens or hundreds of atoms across. Our experts employ electron and atomic force microscopy and optical profilometry to measure flaws in the polish surface. Laser light is scanned at glancing angles along the surface, and the scattered light is measured to see whether there is a crack or residue. Multiple techniques are employed together to unravel the mysteries of CMP, and especially the causes and effects of pathologies. As we push the limits of design and performance, we also challenge new methods and tools for metrology, often costing millions of dollars. But if you want to develop new products at the forefront, this is just one of the costs to stay in the game. One of the serious challenges in polishing semiconductor devices is that we often have to polish two very different materials, such as copper and a dielectric oxide, such as silica. Silica is a hard, brittle, inert ceramic, while copper is a soft, ductile, reactive metal. When we polish something hard and something soft together, it makes sense that the soft material will polish easier and faster. Similarly, when we add a chemical oxidizer, such as hydrogen peroxide, the inert silica will not react with peroxide, but copper will, which will accentuate the difference between oxide and copper polishing rate. As a result, if we have, say, a single isolated line, as we might find in a bond pad, the copper will form a dish, and we will call this process dishing. In an array of fine lines, the composite effect is similar. The greater local mechanical forces on the narrow oxide lines that stick out after the copper dishes causes them to abrade faster, and we get erosion through a similar process as dishing. Sometimes dishing and erosion can remove so much of the metal that the final electrical resistance of the circuit becomes too great. Also, as the next layers are placed on top of the dish surface, it may be difficult to get perfect alignment and the connections will be missed. Usually the ideal state after CMP is the one pictured on the left, but it rarely happens that way. Our slurry designers and CMP engineers have to trick the two surfaces to polish at the same rate through process, particles, and chemistry. Normally we get some dishing and erosion and undesired topography when we have two very different materials, such as tungsten and oxide or copper and oxide. Often, to make sure that the process is precise, the metals will polish, but once they are cleared, the slurry has almost no effect on the underlying oxide. As we continue to over-polish, that is, to continue polishing after the metal is cleared, some of the metal continues to wear away. If there is any effect on the oxide, it is to cause scratches. But polishing one material and stopping on the next is often needed to ensure the right thicknesses and spacings result from CMP. We call this selective CMP, which we see on the left. We can also design slurries that polish both metals and oxides, for example, shown on the right. And if they polish at the same rate, the process is called non-selective. Non-selective CMP is nice because there is less final topography, but it is possible to polish too much and damage the electrical properties. For example, if you remove too much metal, the electrical resistance increases, causing heating, power loss, and signal delay. As is often the case, chip designers and CMP engineers need to work together to make sure that the design and manufacturing process tolerances match. A special type of erosion is pronounced at the interface between two very different materials at the very ends of an array. It is believed to be a function of differences in coefficient of friction and grain structures as the two distinct materials come together. The net effect is a deep fang that occurs between the two materials. This is a fairly common failure mode for CMP, and often requires fine tuning to reduce the fang to acceptable levels. See the surface profile in blue for polishing tungsten arrays with W2000, a legacy CMC product. Most of the array has eroded about 500 angstroms, but at either end it is nearly 1,000. Our scientists have developed a new system, W7300 and W7500, shown in pink and green, that reduce total erosion to less than 200 angstroms and with no fang. Another one of the major CMP failure modes is scratching on the surface. This slide shows some of the major type of scratches generated during polishing. The big chatter mark, small chattering mark, razor, and pitting, all scratches are different in terms of width and depth, and the source and mechanism of the scratch generation are also different, as shown in the table. Typically, large tramp particles, impurities, agglomerated or dried clusters of particles, and even polishing debris, such as PAG fragment that is decorated with particles, all contribute to scratching. Of course, what is polishing at the microscopic scale? It's probably a series of controlled, very tiny scratches. Our goal is to minimize the number of deep scratches and to quickly polish them away before new ones form. Sometimes there is debris from airborne impurities floating around the clean room, or stuff that came in the slurry, pads, cleans, or in storage and handling. Very careful handling of wafers and consumables is important. Sometimes the charges or surface properties of certain particles used in CMP create a strong tendency to stick. Often a final rinse with water or cleaning chemicals is needed, and more there is a need for a slight CMP buff at the end designed to leave the polishing surface clean and pristine. A common failure mode in reactive metals is corrosion. Corrosion is largely a chemical or electrochemical phenomenon, made worse by lower pH and higher oxidative environments, though stress from mechanical processes and microstructure are important. Often corrosion appears as localized pits, though damaged edges on lines can be observed. A good way to reduce corrosion is to protect the surface with chemicals that inhibit oxidation. As is often the case, too much protection can slow down polishing rates. Sometimes non-uniformity from polishing results in a partial failure to clear all the surface you are trying to polish. In the images above, you can see the data on the left and the photo on the right that a large swath of copper is left behind. This is a particularly vivid example of insufficient clearing and non-uniformity. Often it is much less obvious, a few microscopic puddles or some lines that are misshapen. To ensure that all the features are cleared, it is typical to overpolish for several seconds, typically 30 seconds or longer. But this comes with drawbacks. The longer you overpolish for reactive surfaces such as copper, the process continues to remove material, causing topography including dishing and erosion. For more inert surfaces like oxides, overpolish can lead to scratches. This slide shows how the surface is planarized. Normally, the planarization takes place step by step, from local planarization to global planarization, as shown in the cartoon. The local planarization takes place in a low-density area first, since the downforce is more concentrated there. In a high-density area, it takes more time to complete planarization, mainly because the mechanical forces are lower when spread over more features. The graph is showing step height reduction as a function of polishing time with different pattern densities. The step height is quickly reduced in low density areas within a shorter time, but it takes more time in a high density area. Sometimes pattern densities are hard to eliminate. Sometimes we encounter profile issues where the edges polish faster or slower than the center of the wafer. In this image, we plot removal rates as a function of location on the wafer, scanning from the left edge to the right edge. Here we see an edge fast process. Sometimes we see a center fast process. What would that image look like? Our customers do not want to scrap the chips along the edge, so this is a big problem. Usually the CMP engineers address this problem by adjusting the various forces on the tool using a profiling head, small bladders that tune the local profile of downforces. Also, flow rate, downforce, and pad conditioning can help reduce this effect. So, let's try to pull this all together. I hope you have learned that chip making is an important and complex process, a true technological tour de force. There are hundreds of steps in the process of building the array of transistors and interconnects that allow our electronics to do what they do, to store and manipulate information, data, and processes. Things that drive our phones, laptops, MP3 players, GPS, cars, factories, and homes. An important step is chemical mechanical planarization, needed to planarize the surface at several stages during the chip making process, and that CMP involves a tool, a wafer, a slurry, a pad, and a process. Cabot Microelectronics is actively engaged in developing CMP technology and selling pads and slurries that are consumed during CMP. Hopefully, you know that pads and slurries are carefully designed and precision manufactured to ensure performance, consistency, quality, and cost. Pads are engineered thermoplastic polyurethane foams with controlled pores, grooves, and surfaces. Slurries are complex mixtures of nanoparticles and chemicals, all working together to ensure high polishing rates for a very specific wafer surface composition, often tailored and customized for a specific customer and application. Let's quickly look at our product portfolio. Each slurry needs to be customized for a specific surface. In our metals group, we sell slurries for polishing tungsten, copper, tantalum, aluminum, and ruthenium. There is no copper in what we call copper slurry. Rather, there is mainly silica and alumina, and that copper slurry is something used to polish copper, but doesn't contain any. For each of these slurries, there are often very different formulations for polishing chips that are 130 nanometers compared to 90, 65, 45, 32, and 22 nanometers. Also, there are special versions for each of our major customers. For example, the copper slurry that Intel uses at 65 nanometers is quite different from the slurry that TI or TSMC would use. You can see there is a considerable proliferation of products. Our dielectrics product line includes legacy products for polishing interlayer dielectrics and emerging applications involving shallow trench isolation, STI, used to keep one transistor electrically isolated from the next, along with a range of new structures needed to control precise gates made at the front end of the process. Here we might polish polysilicon, silicon carbide, silicon nitride, and with varying selectivities to each. Emerging activities include some leading-edge materials, including novel 3D structures that involve chip packaging. Data storage includes polishing of aluminum coated with nickel foss used in hard disk drives, along with glass and magnetic head materials. ESF, engineered surface finish, includes polishing a variety of materials not necessarily part of the semiconductor transistors or interconnects. Although we have focused on chip-making technology and CMP fundamentals, we should never lose sight of the importance of high-quality manufacturing. Our product quality and consistency and cost and reliable supply assurance together are just as important as the product design and performance, if not more so. It is one relatively simple matter to develop a small laboratory sample of a slurry that polishes in the desired fashion. It is altogether another matter to make millions of gallons of slurry day in and day out that work equally well and at low cost. Our often unheralded team in operations, sourcing, logistics, and quality meet this challenge in a way that is the foundation of CMP's competitive advantages. Our customers are profoundly driven by cost and quality, and more so every day. Poor quality usually results in lost product at our customers. Our customer surveys indicate that yield from CMP is their number one issue. This means that robust design with rigorous supplier quality, Six Sigma capable manufacturing processes, and careful quality control and testing are vital to our continued success. Let me summarize the things that you should know by now. CMP is vital to successfully produce IC devices. CMP involves slurry, a pad, a tool, a wafer, and a process. Each element of CMP is affected by each other. There are many things that can go wrong, and that metrology is also a challenge at the leading edge. Cabot Microelectronics develops and produces slurry, including nanoparticles and chemistry. Each material and node and customer usually requires a unique solution. Cabot Microelectronics develops and produces polishing pads and has a unique design space, including resin hardness, pore size, and pore concentration. And Cabot Microelectronics operations ensures that our customers enjoy high quality and low cost. I hope you enjoyed this brief overview of CMP and now have a good perspective on how it fits into our customers' processes. The science, engineering, and business of CMP presents rich challenges. No matter what your role, there is truly a lifetime of opportunity for each of us to advance this technology. Because of CMP's complexity, do not expect this to be easy. Our customers have invested billions of dollars to provide semiconductor devices to the marketplace and are often frustrated with the challenges of CMP. Like most technologies, it is difficult to achieve the best performance at the fastest speed, lowest cost, and highest quality. Perhaps you too will experience the challenges of CMP. In the end, you will have the satisfaction of knowing that your efforts have made it possible to bring so much enrichment to the world through modern electronic devices. Thank you and good luck.